morning class. Today I'm going to be doing my teaching plan on bacterial vaginosis. So today I have with me a young lady by the name of Courtney who will be assisting me in my teaching. Good morning.
Morning. How are you today?
I'm wonderful.
My goodies, my goodies, my goodies, not my goodies.
I'm glad you could join me today. Mm-hmm. Okay, today, as you know, we're going to be talking about bacterial vaginosis. Uh-huh. And the abbreviation for that would be BV. So that's what we're going to use throughout the course now that I've told you exactly what it is. Okay? Mm-hmm. Okay. So you said you don't know anything about BV at this moment?
Not much at all.
Okay, wonderful. Well, today, hopefully, by the time I'm done teaching you, you will know the causes, some of the symptoms mm-hmm. to watch for. You'll know the way they diagnose it, mm-hmm. some of the treatments that they use, mm-hmm. and ways to prevent BV.
Okay.
Okay. So here's a handout for you.
Thank you.
As far as for causes, and we'll move along the way, and I'll give you more handouts here. But for right now, we're going to be talking about the causes. Okay? So right now, there's three causes that has been known to possibly cause BV. The first one is an imbalance in normal vaginal bacteria, because you know already we naturally have a balance down there in the vaginal area. And so if you have an imbalance in normal vaginal bacteria, that's a good indication possibly that you are occurring BV or some other vaginitis infection. Douching is another one that you want to kind of limit your douching, because it can also cause BV.
Okay.
Frequent intercourse is another possible cause of BV. Although BV is not sexually transmitted, it can be caused by frequent intercourse. Okay. All right. So now that we've discussed a few of the causes that are known, I'm going to talk a little bit about the symptoms. Okay. A few of the symptoms you will want to watch for in BV would be a milky discharge with a fishy kind of foul odor to it. So if you kind of get a fishy, foul kind of discharge, then you might want to kind of maybe watch for it or keep watching it to see if it's getting better or worse.
Okay.
Also, irritation or itching in the vaginal area is another indication possibly of BV. Mm-hmm. Also, itching or burning directly after intercourse is another sign or that is a possible, it's possible to have BV.
Okay.
The way they diagnose BV is during a vaginal exam, they're going to collect some vaginal fluid.
Okay.
They're going to look at it under a microscope, and they're going to see if there's any abnormal bacteria present, okay?
Okay.
And so, if they do happen to find that you have BV, they're going to go in getting ready to be able to treat the BV, okay?
Okay.
Okay, some of the treatments available right now for BV are primarily antibiotics, and two of the antibiotics here are listed right okay. here. And the first one is metronidazole.
Okay.
And the second one is clindamycin.
Okay.
So if they were going to treat you, these are the two that you would probably be treated with. Okay.
Okay.
Now there are also some prevention methods here, and right here that I will be talking about also. Okay, some of the prevention measures are, if I know right now it's the summertime, so you might be going swimming, mm-hmm. you know, very
yes.
often. And so one of the things you want to watch for is changing your bathing suit if it's damp as soon as possible, because this can possibly build up yeast also.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, avoid wearing tight pants or any kind of tight clothes, because that's going to create like a, you know, warm sensation down there, and you know, of course, we know bacteria grows in a warm environment, mm-hmm. and so you want to eliminate tight clothing. Okay. Once again, we talked about douching, so again, you know, possibly try not to douche if at all possible, if you don't have to,
okay.
or talk with your doctor actually about how often you should douche. Okay. You want to wash the vaginal area with unscented soaps. I would try to stay away from scented soaps. I know, as you know, as women, we like to buy a lot of scented soaps and different things that's really not really that good for us. So try to stick to unscented soaps if possible. Okay. If you are a person that wears tampons, change them every 2 to 4 hours because that can also build up some kind of bacteria also. So just kind of watch, you know, when you're using them to change them often. Like I said, every 2 to 4 hours. Okay. All right. Okay, now that I finished teaching you about BV, I want to see if my teaching was effective. So can you tell me some of the causes right now?
Imbalance in normal vaginal bacteria, douching, and frequent intercourse.
Okay, wonderful. Now that you've been able to tell me some of the causes, can you possibly tell me some of the symptoms?
A fishy odor discharge, usually white or gray. Itching, burning, irritation down in the vaginal area.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes after intercourse it can happen, and also after like a period of time after intercourse.
Okay, wonderful. Okay, now that you told me some of the symptoms, can you tell me the way that BV will be diagnosed?
I recall you saying that usually through a vaginal exam where they collect vaginal fluid and look at it up under a microscope and pick out details that are...
Okay, wonderful. Okay, and once they diagnose BV, if you do have it, what will they use for treatment options?
I recall you saying 2 other antibiotics.
All right, that's wonderful. So what are some ways that we can prevent BV?
Not wearing tight clothing. And since you said it's the summertime, of course, we young ladies do swim. And by taking off those swimming clothes as soon as possible.
Mm-hmm.
And also dishing less. Using unscented soap instead of using Smell Good all the time. While using tampons, change them every 2 to 4 hours.
That's correct.
All right,
that's wonderful. Well, it seems that my teaching has been effective here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I just want to know, do you have any questions for me, any concerns to address?
No, I think I've learned all that I need to learn about vaginal infections.
Okay, so you feel comfortable with the information that has been given to you?
Yes, I do.
All right, well, that's wonderful. Well, I'm going to let you go ahead and take these handouts. This is what I'm going to give you to take with you today. This is a pamphlet that you can look through.
Okay.
And although we talked about BV today, there are 2 other common infections that are common among childbearing women also.
Okay.
So there's some information you can read a bit about that, and you can also find out the causes, symptoms, and treatments available for these also if you were to encounter any of those. All right? Okay, is there anything else?
No, thank you.
All right, wonderful. Well, I appreciate you stopping in, and you take care of yourself.
All right, you too. Have a nice day.
You too. Bye.
Bye.
This concludes my presentation of bacterial vaginosis. Thank you all.